Hey guys, how y'all doing out there? It's time for another tutorial from Video Editing Software Guide. Let's get into it. So I've been hearing a lot for a few years about priority settings and how they help PowerDirector run smoother, fix errors, get more CPU cycles running for them. And guess what? I've never tried it before because PowerDirector has always run smoothly for me, but I figured I need to let my PowerDirector peeps know about priority settings in case they need to take advantage of this. Let me explain to you just how it works. If you run your video editing application at normal priority and everything else at normal priority, then it's competing against your other programs for CPU cycles. If you have two processes that both want CPU time or CPU cycles, the one with the higher priority will get that CPU time. So, for example, your computer is doing some background task and you can lower the priority for that background task, or you can raise the priority for PowerDirector to give it priority, and hopefully the theory is it'll work faster, there'll be less errors, everything will smooth out, and it will get all the CPU time or cycles that it needs to be the most efficient. Now that I'm done with the bookworm version of our tutorial, let me go ahead and show you how to get it done. First thing you want to do is open up CyberLink PowerDirector. Once you have it open, you want to open your task manager. There's a few ways you can open a task manager. You can go down to your start button or access the start menu for whatever version of Windows that you have. You can click on that. You can type in task manager. Then you want to look for View running processes with task manager. You click on that and it'll open a task manager. The other way that you can open a task manager is you can do control alt delete on your keyboard, and depending on the Windows version that you should have an option to select start task manager. Now, because PowerDirector is running, if you go to the Processes tab, you should be able to find PowerDirector. I think it's called pdr.exe. Here it is. pdr.exe. You look for that. You right click on it and you go down to set priority. Now you can choose high or above normal. Pick the one that you want. I'm going to select high, and I'm going to get a warning message. It says changing the priority of certain processes could cause system instability. All right. What this means is that it could affect the way that certain programs are running, because some things might need to have a higher priority than PowerDirector. So you may notice that some programs are running differently. If you notice that, all you got to do is come back here and change PowerDirector back to a normal priority. But for right now, I'm going to click on change priority. And now if I go back and check the priority of PowerDirector, it is set to high. So I can close this out. And now PowerDirector has a higher priority than all the other things that have a normal priority or above normal. And it will get the CPU time when it's competing against those programs for those cycles. Now, keep in mind, you have to do this every time you open up PowerDirector. Okay, you can't just do it once, because you have to go to a process that is running in the task manager to set it to a high priority. And unless you got PowerDirector running all the time and you never turn it off, you're going to have to go back and set the priority to high every time you open up PowerDirector. Now, I want you guys to leave me a comment below. Tell me, did changing the priority setting help you speed things up with PowerDirector? Did it stop errors from happening? Did it make the process smoother? Did it make your rendering faster? Let me know in the comments below, all right? If the content in this video helped you, go ahead and click on the thumb, the one that's pointed in the upward direction. And don't forget, subscribe, peeps, all right? Thanks for watching. We'll see you again soon.